11 minutes now gone past 10 a.m. and you're listening to Mainland 98.3 FM, the sound of Lagos. And you know the show that you have to wait for until every Thursday morning every week. We wish we could come on the show, you know, on this show more times than that, but we at least have this window of Thursday mornings 10 a.m. through till 11 a.m. So welcome to Creative Nigeria, a show that tackles issues bordering on culture, technology, festivals, travels, music, hospitality, business, water transportation / water transportation economy, and insurance. And well, that's quite a mouthful, but we try to do this at least once a week so that we get as much coverage as possible. And today is not going to be any different. We always have a great time every time we come on the show. By the way, my name is Bumi Bade Adeniji, and I do this show usually with Mr. Frank Meke, but unavoidably he's absent today, but definitely he should be back next week. He's about the business of the show, you can be sure of that, and we will hear from him about, you know, whatever it is that he has gone on assignment about, definitely next week. Today is jam-packed. We have a full house in the studio with me this morning. We have Dr. Shuaibu Hussein. He is the director of dance, National Troupe of Nigeria, founder Africa Movie Academy Awards, AMA. You know, we talked about that last week. So can I say a very warm welcome to you, sir? Good morning, sir.
Good morning. It's a pleasure to be here.
Great to have you, sir.
Thank you.
And also, well, the Association of Tourism Practitioners of Nigeria inaugurated its board of trustees in Abuja just yesterday. So we'll have full details next week when Frank, who has gone to cover that inauguration, will be back here to give us more information. The president, Hotel Owners and Managers Association of Lagos, that's HOMAL, Chief Samuel Alabi, will be our Villa Square guest next week. So you know you have to look forward to that, and you don't want to miss that explosive outing as well. And I also have this lovely gazelle in the house, this beautiful lady who has come to surprise us today, because she's actually a part of the family. The Naihoto family is part of Creative Nigeria family. So it was a huge surprise, I must say, but it's a huge pleasure to have you in the house. Omolere Afegbai, thank you so much for coming to the house this morning.
Thank you so much for having us here. Compliment of the season.
Thank you. Same to you. Thank you for bringing your bright smile to the show this morning. Right. So, and we also have our weather girl, Ebube, is in the house. You'll be hearing from her soonest when we get to our weather report segment. Meanwhile, we want to do something that we do sometimes on this show. We like to celebrate our own. We like to celebrate our people. We like to celebrate one another. I think we're just really fun people.
Yes.
In Creative Nigeria. So we want to send a really lovely birthday shout out to Amiable Damilola Emmanuel. He is the head man at the Lagos State Waterways Authority, that's LASWA, and he clocks 40. He clocks the big 40 tomorrow, 20th of January 2023. And so we want to say a very big happy birthday from all of us here at Creative Nigeria. Mr. Damilola Emmanuel, happy birthday, many happy returns. We wish you all the blessings of the new year. And as you know, you start off the fourth floor, definitely great things await you. If you've been successful before, guess what? You are in for greater successes. Yeah, if you've seen happiness before, you will enjoy even a bigger level of happiness and joy, and all your dreams, we pray that they come true. Well, that's what we can we can take in this brief intro of our show. Meanwhile, you can actually call the show and just ask questions, talk to us on 090-091-36-000-410. Let me do that again. 091-36-000-410. And you can also send us a message or call us on 070-4902-1560. You can also check us out on social media at creative_Niger_TV, and you will see us right here, what we do in the studio. You can also check out Mainland FM's Facebook page, Instagram page, because we are live on air. So get yourselves ready. It's going to be a wonderful ride. It's going to be a great show. But meanwhile, we'll take a break and we'll be back after this.
Lagos-based hotel and hospitality owner, manager and investor? Are you troubled by certain operational environmental challenges and need help? Then come over to Hotel Owners and Managers Association of Lagos, HOMAL. We provide you hospitality growth opportunities and counseling on prosperity, and also help you mitigate difficult hospitality trade barriers. At HOMAL, we do more, deploying our experience to take care of your interest always. Located at Resort Court, 15 Chief Yusufu Abiodun Road, Oniru, Victoria Island. Call 081-872245 or 0812-425-5995 for more information. HOMO, your interest, our mission.
Fellow Nigerians, have you heard about NICO? National Institute for Cultural Orientation is Nigeria's cultural intelligence and intellectual powerhouse, set up to X-ray the diversity of Nigerian culture, language, history, tradition and ways of life, which binds 200 million Nigerians together, deepening peace, security and national cohesion, with offices across the six geopolitical zones and a culture training school. NICO also partners local and international agencies like UNESCO to harness and validate cultural assets unique and beneficial to a national aspiration. An agency under the Federal Ministry of Information, Culture and National Orientation, NICO Abuja office is located at 23 Kigoma Street, Wuse, Zone 7E. Website info@nico.gov.ng. NICO, a net in culture for national development.
Welcome back. This is still Creative Nigeria here on Mainland 98.3 FM. I have in the house, like I said before, Dr. Shoaibu Husseini, and he will be talking to us. I know it's a little bit difficult. We were talking off air, and I know you told me off air that it's still something you're still trying to come to,
trying to grasp it and process it.
But indeed, we do sympathize. The whole of Nigeria sympathizes, because I know that there's no Nigerian who is a movie lover who does not know about these awards, the YAMA. And she came up with this beautiful brain project, and it did so well. You want to tell us, first of all, tell us about YAMA. What is that all about?
Well, thank you for having me. It's a pleasure to be here on this program
and great in to
this
have
station
you.
As well. The African Movie Academy Awards is a reward system for filmmakers of African descent and those of them that are in the diaspora.
Okay.
And it was established in 2006 by the great piece Aya Musigwe, which I find it difficult to refer to her in the past, founded by her.
Yeah.
And the reason she did that was she had set up African Film Academy. And then she felt that, look, there was a need for us to begin to recognize talents in the area of filmmaking, not just in Nigeria, but in the continent of Africa. Because we were always looking forward to the Oscars, the BAFTAs, and all that, for validation.
Mm.
And so we needed something that would say, okay, look, like the typical lizard, who will jump, come down, and then commend himself.
Yeah.
Why don't we just set up a reward system where we can give recognition to people who are doing very well in the area of film, both in Nigeria, Africa, and in the diaspora? And so she set up this, got the support of the Bayelsa state government.
Wow.
They started it, and then YAMA has come to
they say the rest is history.
18. Now we are going to have the 19th edition this year.
Wow.
So she started it off, and that award system has not only been, not only giving recognition to stars, they are not only made stars, but it has also become like a cultural item. It has become something that has boosted our, you know, the country's tourism, especially local tourism.
Yeah.
Because I remember that Hollywood stars like Forest Whitaker, so many people came down to this country because of the award.
Yeah.
We had people traveling from all over the world to come each time we had the award.
Yeah.
So the award was basically set up by her to reward and to recognize talent in the area of filmmaking, but particularly filmmakers of African descent.
Fantastic. I can't but be impressed, because that's a CV that just stands out. And being a woman, I don't know, how easy was that for her?
Yeah, man, it wasn't easy. You know, that's why it's so much pain for us, because she's a very young woman. I mean, she's just going to be 53 years old this year, you know, and all that. And then she has all these things, all these dreams to develop the industry. You know, first she started with African Film Academy, which is the capacity building arm. You know, and then she felt that, okay, after building capacity, after making the films, can't we recognize people? And then she set up the AMA.
Awards.
It was difficult from the beginning to get it started. A lot of people felt that, oh, it was a Nigerian thing. But as time went on, people started, you know, people
buying,
said, look, let's look at what this lady is doing. She's doing something great, and that's why, you know, people are embracing it. If you were in Nigeria last year when it happened here in Lagos, hosted by the Lagos state government, you will see South Africans, you will see filmmakers from other parts of Africa saying, we don't know what we have with AMA. You know, they will come on stage, raise their country's flag and say they are proud to be in Lagos, they are proud to be in Nigeria, they are proud to be filmmakers.
Yeah.
They don't need the West to validate them. They need, you know, this kind of reward system to show. And the good thing about this reward system is that it's also an avenue where scouts, where programmers, you know, look for films, you know, where look for talents, where they can meet, that they can begin discussions with. And then some of these films have to travel. Like, I remember the last AMAs that we had, four of the films that made it to the finals are their country's entries for the Oscars.
Wow.
So it's a big platform that she put together. And well, maybe what we can do for her is to make sure that that platform doesn't die.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
So, I agree with you fully.
Yeah. So I mean AMAS is there, AFA is there, but beyond all those, she has done a lot in the area of philanthropy. You know, she has also done a lot in the area of creative writing. She has also produced. The thing about Peace is that she's not just an administrator. She's not just someone who sets up those platforms. She's also a producer of films. She produces films. She
That's true.
Films.
I know that.
You know, and she's also a content creator. So there's nothing around film, about film, that she doesn't know about.
She was just a creative person.
Yeah, she was.
Through and through. And I just want to ask, what do you think the movie industry is going to really, really miss about her?
They will miss a lot.
They
will miss it. This was a unifier. She was someone who wanted the industry, you know, to go beyond where it is. She could put in her last breath to make sure that we get recognition, not just for Nollywood, but for the African film industry. She was one person who wanted unity. If you listen to her last speech on the AMA stage, she was talking about collaboration.
Yeah.
She was saying that, look, we don't have to be individualistic in our approach to working. We need to collaborate. Most of the big jobs that you have seen, you know, most of the works that you have seen in Hollywood have been a product of collaboration. But you find out that it's an African thing for you to want to just take the glory alone and
take center stage.
You know, you don't want to, you know, get to someone else and say, okay, look, can you bring this, can you bring that?
I bring mine, you bring yours.
I used to say that there's a particular film that made it so well in this country. It's a product of four companies who came together. I have the creative ability, you have the equipment,
you
can
have
distribute
funds.
And you have funds. Can we come together and produce a film? And that film has been a masterpiece. You know, so she was talking about collaboration, she was talking about unity, she was talking about the need for there to be a policy that will help film, the film industry, not just in Nigeria, but in Africa. She was the champion of all that. And that's why at a point in her life, she took, she vied for the position of the president of the Association of Movie Producers.
Yeah.
I was even telling her at that time that what are you doing with being president of Association of Movie Producers in Nigeria when you should be president of movie producers in the continent?
You know.
She says, no, that we need to begin to put structures down for the industry.
Home.
She started talking about structure. But
I know this is difficult for you. I'm also going to get to a little bit more difficult part. What really happened to her? It's not in the public space.
Well,
are you at liberty to share, or you know, we can just gloss over that?
Well, I mean, she took ill, went to a private facility in Lagos, and she didn't get out of it. That's all. I mean, there's nothing to hide about that. But she went to a facility in Lagos, and then we didn't get our peace back. You know, when she got there. But I mean, we've lost someone. We've lost a creative Amazon.
Yeah.
We've lost a giant. It will be difficult to fill her space, you know. But I mean, she has mentored a lot of people.
Sure.
She has put structures down that we see. I mean, I recall that after this last AMA, because I'm chairman of the selection committee, after the last AMA, she released a program of activity of the AMAs, and even put a date to the 2023 AMA, and said, look, a selection process, and then we are going to run it, end entry, start pre-selection, all this, and have the awards.
So there was always a plan.
No, there was.
She always lays a blueprint out.
I mean, that's why when some people said, peace has gone, AMA will go. I said,
no way. I want to believe
that. That the structures are there.
Exactly.
All we just need is the support of the Ayamo Sigwe Foundation and support of every other partner.
Okay.
Those people who have been sponsoring the project, and then we can go on. AMA has to stay.
Absolutely.
You know, for us to for us to say, okay, this is one legacy
that she has left. Well, I'm going to just in the next like one and a half minutes just give you a chance to give your own personal tribute to her.
It's very difficult to talk about you in the past, because you are one person who will call me up. Beyond AMA, you talk to me about life, about every other thing. But when I didn't get the call on the 5th for us to have a meeting, I knew there was something that was not right. Well, thank you for giving me the opportunity to call you a mentor, to call you a sister, to call you a friend. In fact, you called me brother. That's what you call me. One name came. That's what you always call me.
Okay.
Travel safe.
That's what we all wish her from here as well. A very peaceful rest for her, and may her soul rest in perfect peace. We thank you so much, Doctor, for doing this with us this morning. We know it was a bit difficult.
It was. I mean,
this had to be done.
I told Frank.
Yeah.
That, I mean, if not because of him, I mean, this is an Egbon. This is an icon.
Yeah.
In our industry, in the culture travel industry. So when he told me, I said, Egbon, I don't want to say no to you, but I will try. You know. So it's a pleasure to be here, and it's nice talking about her. You know.
Yeah.
You know.
The way to even keep her memory, you know, is to just make sure that her legacy just keeps, you know, keep up with her legacy. Make sure that every year we hold that awards, and I know many movies from here on out will be dedicated to her memory.
I know.
Most definitely. Well, that's all we can take on that segment. Thank you so much for being here. We will be back after this break. Stay with us. We'll be back.
Anchor Insurance, we will always turn up for our clients when it really matters. We put in 100% because they mean the world to us. If you desire insurance services built around you, where claims are paid promptly, then come to Anchor Insurance. Anchor Insurance, where insurance truly works.
Welcome back. Creative Nigeria still on your radio, and my name is Bumi. Well, we move on now to our weather segment, where we have our weather report being brought to us by Ebube James. Ebube, good morning.
Good morning. It's nice to be back again.
Great to see you. What's our weather like this beautiful day? You know, one of the things that we want to even begin to do with the weather, you know, is to go a little beyond our shores. So what's it like in Nigeria, and then what's it like, you know, beyond? So today.
So today we'll just take just Lagos. So next time we're just going to
take it a little beyond.
So today in Lagos, the weather is expected to be good. So we're to expect a humid weather with a blend of sun and clouds. And then in the evening, or rather at night, we should expect a partly clear to partly cloudy weather. The maximum predicted temperature will be hot at 33 degrees Celsius, while the minimum temperature will be a moderately hot 25 degrees Celsius. Wow. Sunrise was at about 7:03 this morning, and the sunset is expected to be at about 6:51. And daylight is estimated to last for at least 11 hours 48 minutes. This is the weather report from the Weather Channel, brought to you by
Report. We move into our new segment, which is sponsored by Heck Travels.
Michael, you travel frequently and hardly complain of travel services. How do you come by?
I use the services of one of the best travel outfits in Nigeria, Heck Travel Agency.
Heck Travel Agency?
Oh yes, Heck Travel Agency takes care of travel plans, ticketing, insurance, visa, and provides pocket-friendly fares helpful in this new normal.
Really? What about holiday packages for families?
Trust Heck Travel Agency on that too. On request, the agency provides both local and international tourism holiday packages with detailed country situation reports, car hire, and hotel reservations.
Where can I locate Heck Travel Agency?
Very easy, my friend. Heck Travel Agency is located in number 2 Ibro Avenue, Rainbow Estate, Trans Amadi, River State. Telephone 0907-893-5167. Lagos office, Parkview Estate, Ikoyi. Telephone 0806-2463-292. Heck Travel Agency, always in touch.
And here's our culture, technology, festivals, travels, hospitality, music, business, movies, brown water economy, insurance news, and sports tourism in collaboration with Heck Travels. Brought to you by Creative Nigeria, edited by Frank McKay and read by yours truly. The World Economic Summit kicks off in Davos, an icy town in Switzerland Alps, a ski resort which has become the economic intervention and solution hotspot over the years. Switzerland has other ski areas such as Pischa, Rhinehorn, Jakobshorn, and Parsim. There is the Glacier Express Wanderlust Ride, which connects Davos to Matterhorn. From next week, Creative Nigeria Business Desk shall bring you exclusive tidbits on happenings at the gathering of global economic heads at Davos. The United States tops the list of top team with 10 eggheads, and Nigeria, Africa's biggest economy with no show appearance. Inflation has dropped in the United States from December last year, same in Nigeria for the first time in 11 months. Though energy issues ride like a wounded lion at 3% in the United States, in Nigeria, the inflation drop down did not impact positively on economic outlook, saying in 2023, the rundown is going to be gritty and hard. In other news, about 17 new vital metals impactful on technology such as computing, renewable resources up at 400% by the year 2030. Let's look at India, where Indic models by its gains for a lead on global batteries manufacturing markets. Good for India. And finally, Africa's second biggest economy, energy crisis never witnessed in its history, fueling power cuts to families lasting up to 8 hours. Also, 50% of its 10 baseline. Well, that's the news, as brought to you by Heck Travels, edited by Frank McKay, and read.
Michael.
Travel agency.
Heck Travel Agency?
Oh yes, Heck Travel Agency takes care of travel plans, ticketing, insurance, visa, and provides pocket-friendly fares helpful in this new normal.
Really? What about holiday packages for families?
Trust Heck Travel Agency on that too. On request, the agency provides both local and international tourism holiday packages with details to Ebro Avenue, Rainbow Estate, Trans Amadi, River State. Telephone 0907-893-5167. Lagos Office, Parkview Estate, Ikoyi. Telephone 0806-2463-292. Heck Travel Agency, always in touch.
Stop paying attention to the hustle and bustle of Lagos. Take a chill pill.
Problem in all the feelings.
Welcome back. And before I take you to our Sava, talk to our listeners this morning. So Obaleri, that is representing Naihoto this morning. Good morning again. And
you know now, you guys ended up surprising me.
Well, I know you were so excited.
Definitely. But time is too short.
I know. Well, definitely you will come back.
Yes, of
and talk
course
to
I
us
will.
About so, what Naihoto has been up to.
Presently, Naihoto is training displaced youth, women, and widowed women.
Wow.
In empowering them with social economic skills, you know, to also add value.
Wow.
Yes. 22.
Yeah.
We had another training in SOAP.
Mm-hmm.
They were like, you know, they were not expecting it. You know, enable rather than you going to, you know, hire yourself out for something, training them. But we said empowerment, right?
Yes.
So there was a starter pack.
Oh, fantastic.
So help actually put it to good use.
We will definitely have you back to come and talk to us about this and to tell our people, our listeners, that there are still opportunities. So we must have you come back, please. But thank you so much for coming on the show.
Thank you for.
And its capital is Gusau. In the year 1996, the then military administration of late General Sani Abacha detached the Zamfara state from Sokoto state with an area of 38,418 square kilometers, the earliest of Zamfara. It extends up to the bend of River Rima to the city-state. Its capital has shifted with the fortunes of the kingdom from place to place like Dutse and Burning Zamfara. It is bordered to the north. It has a population of 9,278,873 people according to the 2006 census and contains 14 local Bari, Dukawa, Bisa, that's the Busawa and Zabarma ethnic communities. The state capital is an important commercial center with a large population of other peoples from different parts of Nigeria. Hausa is the official language of that state, and other main languages spoken in Zamfara are English, gold, chromite, granite, clay, limestone, camovita. Religions also remain, but they have the fewest followers. These religions are mainly practiced in ancient settlements like Dutse and Kwata Kwashi. Zamfara was the first state in Nigeria to introduce the Sharia law during the tenure of Ahmad Sani Yerima, the former governor of the state. Zamfara State holds some number of tourist attractions which are of historical or religious importance. These include Jata, an ancient settlement of Zamfara located around the hill with a large cave around where traditional practices were performed. Major agricultural products include millet, guinea corn, maize, rice, groundnut, cotton, tobacco, and beans. So now you know, about Zamfara State. It's a place you can, you may want to visit, of course, with your safety assured pre-travel, most definitely. But that's it. That segment was brought to you by Topaz Travels and Tours.
Hello there. The world of travel changes in seconds, and border post requirements needs the touch of a professional to help you navigate through the challenges of airline cancellation, delays, and health requirements. At Topaz Travels and Tours, we help you keep eyes on the ball, processing your travel needs with ease, taking your stress away. For your international and local travel tickets, travel insurance, reservations, hotel bookings, car hire services, and visa guidance, you can trust us to deliver as your ultimate choice. You can reach us via WhatsApp on 080-9401-5458 or call 080-3313-8658 or visit our corporate office at Suite F8, First Floor, Febsen Mall, Plot 2425, Herbert Macaulay Way, Wusei Zone 4, Abuja. Email info@topaztravel.com.ng. Topaz Travels and Tours. Stress-free travel.
Welcome back. So we move now to our music segment. This is a very, very popular song. I usually don't like to introduce a song before we play it. So I want to just have us play the song and then have us dance a little. We did have a bit of low moments during the show, so we just want to pick it up and just have a smile, have a dance, and just celebrate. You remember that we also celebrating Lazwa Head in the person of Mr. Damilola Emmanuel. So this is also for you, Mr. Damilola Emmanuel.
Merciful God. Merciful God.
Indeed, that is the song, and I know that that's a song that most of our listeners should be familiar with, coming from the legend himself, Chief Sonny Ade. And he's that song, for those who don't really get it, those who don't speak the Yoruba language, it's a prayer. It's such a beautiful prayer. And what more can we pray for? You know, in the past you know, few months, 1 year, we've seen so many deaths of young people, you know. So the best that we can do is just to call on God, because he's the holder of life, he's the giver of life, you know, he gives it, he takes it. And so we just want to just call on his mercy, you know, from here at Creative Nigeria. Any thoughts on this song, Omoliri? Because growing up, I know that whenever we had those occasions where maybe there was a chieftaincy title being conferred on someone, things like that, you know, they like to play the song because it's just a song that just asks for God's mercy.
Yes, it's actually a song of gratitude.
Yeah.
As in being, you know, showing that you are grateful for life. Fine. Mm. The country may not be what we want it to be. Even our life, our whatever, maybe we've set goals and we have not been able to achieve them.
Yeah.
And we may be passing through issues, you know, we have lost loved ones.
Yeah.
But in everything, we have to give thanks.
Absolutely.
You
know,
because I was listening to somebody yesterday and said, if you decide to focus on majorly the negatives that you are going, the storms, then the storms will just continue to magnify.
Exactly.
So you just have to find that, even if it's one positive thing, focus everything you have on it, and the universe will work it out.
Absolutely. I like that. The universe will work it out. Ube, your thoughts on this?
Like she said, it's a very good song. You can most, I feel like the last time I heard this song,
do you know this song, by the way?
I know this song. Yeah, of course I know this song. So my uncle chose a lot of parties.
Okay.
Shagging Ogun State.
Uh-huh.
So during all those parties, he usually plays this type of song.
Yeah.
So yeah, I'm familiar with it. So it's just a way of saying thank you.
Yeah.
Especially when, because the party brings everybody together.
Together, yes.
The whole family is around, everyone is lively.
Yeah.
We are eating, drinking, snapping. Yeah. So it's just a song that shows how grateful we are for everything.
So this is a song that your generation can actually relate with as
well.
Yeah.
Okay. And I just wish our viewers could notice Ebube's frame. I've been so mesmerized.
I've told her already.
I can look at it all day. I mean, it's so artistic.
Thank you.
I love imagine. Beautiful.
I spent better days of my years trying to avoid using glasses. So when I eventually couldn't avoid
it,
anymore,
have to make it look good.
I had to make exactly.
You're my team. You're my kind of person.
I mean, I want to be like you when I grow up.
Well, that's about all we'll be able to take on the show this morning. I'm happy we're ending on a smiling note. It is, you know, the whole movie industry is still, you know, is mourning. But you know, at the end of every cloud, you know, at the edge of every cloud, they say there is always a silver lining. Get your PVCs and make sure that you vote in the month of February. We're just weeks away from the elections. And here on Creative Nigeria, we do welcome you. You want to come talk about you know, what you want to do, how you want people to vote for you and all of that, Creative Nigeria welcomes you, and of course at very, very good rates. Meanwhile, we'll be back on your radio same time next week. That's at 10:10 a.m. here on Mainland 98.3 FM. many major thanks to Omobola Sandra, who has been on the console for us. Thank you for all you do. Thank you, Omoliri, for coming.
Thank you for having us.
Thank you for spicing up the show this morning. Thank you, Bibi, for all you do. And for all the people behind the scenes, I know there are people in the engine room doing major work. We appreciate all of you as well. Nonso, major shout out. And we are closing the curtain on the show, but we want to leave you in the able hands of Chief Sonny Ade with Merciful God.
Merciful God.